Hello friends, I am Siddharth and today I am going to talk about the short-term capital gains tax in the context of equity and debt-oriented mutual funds and all about their rules, their applicability, their criteria, their tax rate as well. So first let us understand as to what is the short-term capital gains tax in the context of equity-oriented mutual funds. It so happens that if you invest into an equity mutual fund or an equity oriented mutual fund for that matter and keep your money invested up till 1 year or less than 1 year, then whatever gain you make in during that holding period, that gain will attract short term capital gains tax. So for example, if you invest today rupees 1 lakh in an equity mutual fund and you take out your money in any time less than 1 year or up till 1 year, not more than that, mind you, then suppose you are coming out with a capital of 1,15,000. You invested 1 lakh and you took out 1,15,000. So that means you are having a capital gain of 15,000. So you are supposed to pay short-term capital gains tax on it. So what's the rate? It is the flat rate of 15% as per the Income Tax Department rules. So 15% of 15,000 is the flat rate applicable for all the individuals. It is as simple as that. Now similarly, when we talk about the short-term capital gains tax in the context of debt-oriented mutual funds, the rules here are a bit different. Particularly when we talk about the threshold period, just like in the equity, the minimum criteria was 1 year, no? But here in the minimum criteria is 3 years. So if you are investing into a debt-oriented mutual fund, or if you might have already invested into a debt-oriented mutual fund, and now you're wondering as to what will be my taxation if I book profits after investing, say for 2 years, 3 months has already passed since you invested. Now you want to take out your money, of course, at some gains. Then you are wondering what is going to be my taxation. So taxation is very simple again. The Income Tax Department rule says that before 3 years or up till 3 years, if you are staying invested into a debt market mutual fund and you are having some gains when you get out of that fund, then you have to pay tax as per your tax slab. So what does that mean? In India, we have 3 tax slabs, 5%, 20% and 30%. So in whichever tax bracket you fall into, you are going to pay tax accordingly. So if you fall into 20% tax bracket, then again, continuing the previous example of the equity one, if you have invested 1 lakh rupees and you take out your money after 2 years, 3 months and you get a capital gain of 15,000. So how much tax you are going to pay on it? As per your tax slab, and you are falling into 20%, so you will pay 20% on 15,000. If you fall into 5%, you will pay 5% on that amount. Or if you fall into 30%, then you will pay 30% on that amount. This is the Income Tax Department rules regarding the debt market mutual fund. So I hope, my friends, you have understood what is the calculation or what is the criteria for the short-term capital gains tax on both the debt and equity-oriented mutual funds. See you in the next video, guys. Thank you.